So today we will read from Srivilapa Kusumanjali, verse number 19.
Danas čitamo Vilapa Kusumanjali, stih 19.
O Bhavini, beautiful or emotional girl.
O Bhavini, prekrasna, emocionalna djevojko.
When can I diligently bring clay mixed with camphor?
Kada ću u tvoju sobu brižljivo donijeti glinu pomiješanu s kamforom?
Along with scented water into your room.
I mirišljavom vodom u tvoju sobu kada ću donijeti?
I am so sorry to interrupt. I can hear Croatian translation in my headphones.
Yes, it is going directly, not anymore in the room.
Aha, okay.
I have to follow your reading.
Acha, grave. Okay, sorry, I start again. Oh, Bhavini, beautiful or emotional girl.
O Bhavini, prekrasna, emocionalna djevojko.
When can I diligently bring clay?
Kada ću brižljivo u tvoju sobu donijeti glinu pomiješanu s kamforom?
Mixed with camphor, along with scented water.
Kada ću donijeti glinu pomiješanu s kamforom i mirišljavom vodom u tvoju sobu?
Wash your lotus-like feet with a stream of this water.
I oprati tvoja lotosova stopala s mlazom te vode.
In a place suitable for washing your lotus feet.
Na mjestu koje je povoljno za pranje tvojih stopala.
And dry them with my hair.
A potom ih osušiti vlastitom kosom.
O Bhavini, beautiful or emotional girl.
O Bhavini, prekrasna, emocionalna djevojko.
When can I diligently bring clay mixed with camphor?
Kada ću brižljivo donijeti glinu pomiješanu s kamforom?
Along with scented water.
I mirišljivom vodom u tvoju sobu.
Wash your lotus-like feet with a stream of this water.
Oprati tvoje lotosova stopala mlazom te vode.
In a place suitable for washing your lotus feet.
Na mjestu koje je prikladno za pranje tvojih stopala.
And dry them with my hair.
A potom ih osušiti vlastitom kosom.
The service of Radharani is not like the service of the Supreme Personality of Godhead.
Služenje Radharani ne nalikuje služenju svevišnje božanske osobe.
It is the service of ecstatic love personified.
To je služenje otjelovljene zanosne ljubavi.
Mm. In his Prem Amboj Maranda Stavaraj, Sri Raghunath Das has written.
u svojoj Preman Bođa Maranda Stavarađi Raguna Das je napisao.
Her form is born from the glistening thought gem of Mahabal.
Njezina je pojava rođena iz blještećeg kamenja mudraca Mahabave.
Mahabhava Chintamani Radhara Svarupa Chaitanya Charitamrita. Where are the insignificant living entities and where is that Mahabhava?
Gdje su beznačajna živa bića, a gdje je ta Mahabhava?
So this is a small paragraph which Rasamayi read, and I would like to share something, and Jananda Maharaj, please help me.
Ovo je kratki paragraf koji nam je Rasamayi pročitala. Ja bih nešto sada htio podijeliti sa vama i molim Jananda Maharaj da mi pomogne.
It is said that service of Sri Radharani is not like the service of Supreme Personality of Godhead.
Rečeno je da služenje Radharani nije jednako kao služenje svevišnje božanske osobe.
So the question is, what is the difference?
Pitanje je u čemu je razlika.
When devotee serve the Supreme Personality of Godhead, he is serving according to the rules, strict rules, regulations, in the formal way.
Kada bhakta služi svevišnju božansku osobu, tada on služi u skladu sa pravilima i propisima na formalan način.
In this service, there is no any exchange of intimacy.
I u toj službi tada nema nikakve razmjene prisnosti.
And this kind of service devotee is doing actually from the distance.
I bhakta,
emotional distance.
Bhakta tu službu radi sa distance, sa udaljenosti u smislu emocionalne distance.
And through this kind of service he is full of awe and reverence.
I dok tako služi, on je prepun strahopoštovanja.
And for him, it's very important that he strictly follows rules and regulations for serving the Supreme Personality of Godhead.
I za njega je vrlo bitno da striktno slijedi pravila i propisa u skladu sa služenjem svevišnje božanske osobe.
And we call it Vaidhi Bhakti.
To nazivamo Vaidhi Bhakti.
But here, in Raga Bhakti, in spontaneous, loving service, devotee has to serve with full emotions.
Ali ovdje, u Raga Bhakti, u načinu služenja, spontanom načinu služenja, bhakta mora služiti sa potpunom prisnošću, sa potpunim emocijama.
And there is no whiff of awe and reverence.
I tada tu nema ni traga strahopoštovanja.
Because if there is some small feeling of reverence, it will be obstacle.
Jer ako postoji samo tračak strahopoštovanja, to će predstavljati zapreku.
This obstacle can be blockage for spontaneous love.
I ta zapreka će biti prepreka, biti će blokada za spontanu ljubav.
And we call it Raga Bhakti Sadhana.
I to je tada Raga Bhakti Sadhana.
I would like to say that actually in this Raga Bhakti everything is important which brings devotee to the emotional level.
Htio bih napomenuti da u Raga Bhakti je važno sve što može Bhaktu dovesti do tog emocionalnog stupnja, do emocionalnog nivoa.
And we can see directly from the words. First word is O Bhavini, who addressing Ishtadev with full emotions.
I to već možemo vidjeti na početku stiha, kada Ragunat oslovljava Svamini sa Bhavini, i to oslovljavanje je prepuno emocija.
Yes. Ragunat is so close to Radhika and he is calling her, O Bhavini, my dear, all emotional girl, mistress.
Ragunat je toliko blizan Svamini da je naziva Bhavini, o prekrasna emocionalna djevojko.
I'm sure that Gurudev and Jananda Maharaj can speak more about this Bhavini, but I will jump a little bit over and say next thing. In Raga Bhakti, although it is spontaneous service,
Ja ću sad, iako znam da bi Gurudev i Jananda Maharaj mogli reći još nešto, ja ću samo reći da je Raga Bhakti spontana služba.
But it is also careful service.
Ali je također i vrlo pažljiva služba koja se radi s velikom pažnjom.
Very careful and very expertly done. It doesn't mean that if it is spontaneous, this is some kind of improvisation.
Što znači da ne znači zato što je spontano da treba biti improvizacija, da pače treba se raditi vrlo pažljivo i sa velikom predanošću, velikom usredotočenošću.
The next thing in the verse is actually the place where this intimate service is done.
Druga stvar koju vidimo iz stiha je mjesto na kome se ta služba obavlja.
Room. Personal Radhika's room.
Radhikina soba, njena privatna soba.
Who can enter in this private place, in this private room?
Tko može ući na to privatno mjesto, u tu njenu privatnu sobu?
Only someone who is so intimate and completely on the level of spontaneous, full of love service.
Samo onaj tko je vrlo prisan i prepun ljubavi za tu spontanu, predanu s ljubavlju službu.
Loving relationship is necessary. And in the private room, this loving relationship is becoming more and more intense.
Potreban je odnos ljubavi i na tom privatnom mjestu taj odnos i ta ljubav dolaze još više do izražaja. Oni su vrlo intenzivni na takvom mjestu.
Why we are talking about this? Because this is a difference of serving Supreme Personality of God and service Radhika.
I zašto to spominjemo? Zato što je to razlika između služenja svevišnje božanske osobe ili služenja Radharani.
Next thing is, Tulasi wants to touch Radhika's feet and not only touch, but to wash.
Sljedeće što se spominje u stihu je da Radhika želi Tulasi želi dotaći Radhikina stopala i ne samo dotaći, nego ih oprati.
And where she is washing these feet?
I gdje ona pere ta stopala?
In a suitable place, also intimate place.
I ona to čini također na vrlo intimnom mjestu i na povoljnom mjestu.
And finally, the culmination of this intimate seva is that Tulasi is drying with her own hair Swamini's lotus feet.
I kulminacija te seve je da Tulasi na kraju suši radikina lotosova stopala svojom vlastitom kosom.
So this is the difference between service of Supreme Personality of Godhead with full awe and reverence and service with personification of love with ecstatic love mood.
I to je razlika između služenja svevišnje božanske osobe u skladu sa strogim slijeđenjem pravila i propisa ili služenja otjelovljenja ljubavlji sa potpunim raspoloženjem ljubavi i privrženosti.
So, I said something. And maybe Gurudev, Jayananda Maharaj or someone else can continue. Radhe.
So, this is a very wonderful explanation.
Ovo je vrlo lijepo objašnjenje.
And I may say, service of Sri Radha and the service of Supreme Personality of Godhead, service of Krishna,
I mogao bih reći da je služenje Šri Rade ili služenje svevišnje božanske osobe, odnosno Krišne.
So, service of Supreme Personality Godhead, it may be Ujjvala Rasa.
Služenje svevišnje božanske osobe može biti i Ujjvala Rasa.
But service of Sri Radharani,
ali služenje Radharani,
is Unnato Ujjvala Rasa.
Je unatođvala rasa.
So, what's the difference?
Koja je razlika?
So, service of the Supreme Personality, it may say there's some tinge of some personal desire.
Razlika je u tome što kad služimo svevišnju božansku osobu, tu može biti malo osobne želje.
Give me something.
Daj mi nešto.
Oh, give me my enjoyment.
Pruži mi uživanje.
I want to enjoy with you.
Želim uživati s tobom.
Some kind of personal tendency to some enjoyment.
Znači, može se pojaviti osobna tendencija prema uživanju.
But this service of Radharani, especially Manjari Kinkari,
ali ovo služenje Radharani, posebno služenje Manjari ili Kinkari,
that they don't have any tinge of personal desire.
One nemaju ni trunčicu osobne želje.
So just Kinkari, Manjari, they desire just to please Srimati Radharani.
Kinkari i Manjari žele jedino zadovoljiti Srimati Radharani.
So who is Mahababa personified.
Koja je otjelovljenje Mahabave.
So therefore, Kinkari and Manjari is tasting highest Baba.
Iz toga Kinkari i Manjari kušaju najuzvišeniju Babu.
Because among the gopis, Radharani is highest, best, among the best gopi, best Supreme Bhakta among the all Bhakta, among the all gopis.
Jer Radharani je među svim Bhaktama i među svim gopijama najuzvišenija. Ona je najbolji Bhakta i najbolja gopija, najsavršenija gopija.
Why?
Zašto je to tako?
Because Radharani could fulfill all desire, all Krishna's desire.
Zato što Radharani može ispuniti sve Krišnine želje.
Completely.
U potpunosti.
And so, but and to serve Radharani is Kinkari and Manjari. They are doing such wonderful seva. Who serve Radha's Moham best way?
I Kinkari i Manjari rade najdivniju sevu, jer tko može služiti Radha Mohana bolje od njih?
So, This is a very interesting point, Radhe Radhe.
To je jako lijepa poanta.
The essential portion of the Lord's pleasure potency is named prema, love of God.
Suština gospodinove energije zadovoljstva naziva se prema, ljubav prema Bogu.
And that prema is known to consist of blissful transcendental flavors.
I ta se prema sastoji od blaženih transcendentalnih draži.
The quintessence of prema is mahabhav.
Suština preme je mahabhava.
And the personification of that mahabhav is the goddess Radha.
A otjelovljenje te mahabhave je božica Radha.
Čaitanya Charita. Therefore, for engaging in the service of Sri Radha, one must adopt a favorable mood.
Stoga je za služenje Sri Rade nužno prihvatiti povoljno odgovarajuće raspoloženje.
This is one also important point that if we want to serve, we have to do it in a favorable way.
Ovdje je istaknuta važna poanta da ukoliko želimo služiti, to moramo raditi na povoljan, odgovarajući način.
So it means we have to be infused with proper bhava that we can serve bhava mai in the proper way.
Što znači da moramo biti ispunjeni pravom bhavom da bismo mogli služiti bhava mai na odgovarajući način.
Rupa Goswami is speaking in Nectar of Devotion actually that for every service, two things are necessary.
Rupa Goswami u Nektaru devocije ističe da je za svaku službu su potrebne dvije stvari, neophodne su dvije stvari.
Bava and Chešta.
Bava i Chešta.
So proper emotion, bava.
Prava emocija, odnosno bava.
And proper activity, Chešta.
I odgovarajuća djelatnost, aktivnost, odnosno Chešta.
So the living entities who are in conditioned state of life, they have to learn this bhava and Chešta from someone who already is on that level.
Živa bića koja su u uvjetovanom stanju, oni moraju tu bavu i Češtu učiti od nekoga koji je već na tom stupnju, koji ih posjeduje.
They have to receive bava and through bava develop their bava deha in which they will do proper Češta or activity.
Oni moraju od nekoga primiti tu bavu i razviti svoju bava dehu i onda djelujući kroz tu bava dehu ispunjavati odgovarajuće služenje, odnosno kroz bava dehu djelovati.
Because to approach Radharani and Krishna Jiva cannot do it in any body which happened to Jiva. This kind of body has to be received.
Da bi prišli radi Krišni, živa bića ne mogu prići im bilo kojim tijelom koje imaju, nego to tijelo moraju dobiti, moraju primiti od nekoga.
This body have to be received through Guru, but also through Radharani.
Oni moraju to tijelo primiti od Gurua, odnosno od Radharani.
And Radhika wants that Jiva serves her and approach close to her in this particular Swarup or Bhava Deha, like we say.
I Radharani želi da je ta Jiva služi kroz to tijelo, tim tijelom, u svom Swarupu, u toj Bhava Dehi.
So this is Radhika's desire. We cannot go over Radhika's desire and said to her, and say to her, I want to serve you in this form. No, it doesn't work like this.
To mora biti Radhikina želja i mi ne možemo samo reći Radhiki, ja to ne želim, ja te želim služiti kroz neku drugu formu, na drugačiji način. To je nešto što se dobiva od Radharani.
Because she has to give Jiva body, Swarup, which she likes. And she is doing it through representative, her kinkari.
Ona to tijelo daje, koje ona želi svojim, daje Jivama kroz svoje predstavnike, preko svoje kinkari.
So this is general explanation, but sadhaka has to practice this kind of sadhana.
Ovo je generalno objašnjenje, ali sadaka mora prakticirati tu vrstu sadhane, tu vrstu prakse.
And in that way he will go in the proper favorable mood.
I tada će djelovati u odgovarajućem povoljnom raspoloženju.
Because without favorable mood for the pleasure of Radhika, it will be not possible to approach and to serve.
Jer bez povoljnog raspoloženja u skladu sa Radhikom nemoguće će biti prići i služiti je.
Therefore, for engaging in the service of Radha, one must adopt a favorable mood.
Stoga je za služenje Šri Rade nužno prihvatiti povoljno odgovarajuće raspoloženje.
In the previous verse, Sri Raghunatha attained his desired devotional service.
U prethodnom stihu Sri Raghunath je dostigao svoju željenu devocijsku službu.
But when that vision vanishes, the agony of separation becomes intolerable.
Međutim, kada je ta vizija nestala, tjeskoba i bol uslijed odvojenosti postala je nepodnošljiva.
Weeping and weeping, he prays.
Plačući i jadikujući, on se moli.
Ai bhavini, beautiful or emotional girl.
Ai bhavini, prekrasna, emocionalna djevojko.
When can I diligently bring soft clay mixed with camphor?
Kada ću brižljivo donijeti meku glinu pomiješanu s kamforom,
along with scented water
i mirisnom vodom tvoju sobu.
Wash your lotus-like feet with a stream of this water.
Oprati tvoje lotosova stopala mlazovima ove vode.
And wipe them with my hair.
I osušiti ih vlastitom kosom.
What is the meaning of the address Pavini?
Koji je smisao oslovljavanja imenom Bavini?
The address is made in a spiritual vision.
To obraćanje se događa u duhovnoj viziji.
Swamini is all emotional, and so are her maidservants.
Swamini je sve emocionalna, a takve su i njezine sluškinje.
Swamini is ecstatic about her lover.
Swamini je u zanosu zbog svog ljubavnika.
And the maidservants ecstatically love Swamini.
A sluškinje sa zanosom vole Swamini.
This is description. What does it mean to serve personified ecstatic love?
Ovo je opis kako služiti otjelovljenu ljubav.
So, Radhika is Bhavini, but her maid servant is also Bhavini.
Radhika je Bhavini, ali i njezina sluškinja je također Bhavini.
And only someone who is Bhavini can serve the source of Bhava.
I samo onaj tko je Bhavini može služiti izvor Bhave.
So this is unique position of Manjaris.
I ovo je jedinstveni položaj Manjari.
In their heart is completely situated and Radhika's Mahabhav.
U njihovom srcu je postoji Radhikina Mahabhava.
Because without this Mahabhava in the hearts of Kinkaris.
Jer bez te Mahabhave u srcima Kinkari,
they will be not able to serve embodiment of Mahabhava and Raso Vaisaha Krishna.
One ne bi bile sposobne služiti Mahabhavu i Raso Vaisaha, odnosno Krishnu.
And Tulasi Manjari or Raghunath is on the stage actually where he feels this Bhava. He is completely immersed in this Bhava, and because of that, he is praying to Radhika and addressing her, O Bhavini.
I Raghunath je potpuno uronjen u tu Bhavu, on je potpuno ispunjen to Bhavom i zbog toga oslovljava Radhiku sa O Bhavini.
Yes. And we can see here that Swamini is ecstatic about her lover.
I ovdje možemo vidjeti da je Radhika u zanosu zbog svog ljubavnika.
And maidservants are ecstatic in their love for Swamini.
A sluškinje su jednako tako u zanosu uslijed svoje ljubavi prema Radharani, prema svojoj Swamini.
So Radhika example of one-pointedness, one-pointed love to Krishna.
Radhikin primjer jednousmjerenosti, jednousmjerene ljubavi prema Krišni.
And eternal kinkari, nitya siddha kinkari, is example of one-pointness of love to Radhika.
A nitya siddha kinkari je primjer jednousmjerene ljubavi prema Radhiki, prema vlastitoj svamini.
So we need desperately, we need to take shelter of this Radha's maidservants.
I stoga mi imamo očajničku potrebu da uzmemo utočište ovih Radhikinih sluškinja.
Radhi.
So this is so Babini means someone who has Baba, someone who has Mahababa, or someone who in Mahababa.
Bavini znači onaj tko je Mahabava, tko ima Mahabavu ili tko je Mahabava.
So this we understand to become Kinkari or to become a maid servant of Radharani, we need feeling Baba.
Da bismo postali Radhikine Kinkari, Radhikine Dasi, mi trebamo bavu, trebamo emocije.
And then Radharani has highest emotion, Mahabhava.
Radharani ima najuzvišene emocije, ona ima Mahabhava.
So if you want to get this Mahabhava,
i ako želimo dobiti tu Mahabhavu,
so we need to beg, borrow, steal from someone who has it.
Mi moramo moliti, posuditi ili ukrasti nekoga tko to ima.
So to beg, borrow, steal, we need Sajjati Sangha.
Za to nam je potrebna Sajjati Sangha.
So just I want to.
Bhamini is ecstatic about her lover.
Bhamini je u zanosu zbog svog ljubavnika.
And the maid servants ecstatically love Swamini.
A sluškinje sa zanosom vole Swamini.
This cannot be experienced with a scattered mind.
To se ne može doživjeti, to se ne može iskusiti rasijanim umom.
It is necessary, therefore, to bring her mood into the heart.
Zato je neophodno dovesti njezino raspoloženje u svoje srce.
Something will be understood when the conditions become even slightly favorable and some help is given.
Nešto od toga moći ćemo razumjeti ukoliko se stvore bar donekle povoljni uvjeti i ako dobijemo odgovarajuću pomoć.
What, which kind of favorable condition it is?
Na kakve se ovdje povoljne uvjete misli?
Like Jananda Maharaj said, Sajjati Sangha.
Kao što je Jananda Maharaj rekao, to je Sajjati Sangha.
Devotees who are in the same mood, who are trying to develop the same mood.
Društvo bhakta koji su u istom raspoloženju i koji žele razviti isto raspoloženje.
Under the guidance of someone who is already in that stage of perfection.
Pod vodstvom osobe koja je već na stupnju savršenstva.
So if we use properly these favorable circumstances or conditions,
i ako na pravi način iskoristimo te povoljne okolnosti,
they can, then we can use this help in the proper way.
Tada ćemo moći na pravi način iskoristiti pomoć koju dobijemo.
Because sometimes help can be around us.
Jer ponekad mi možemo imati određenu pomoć, ona može biti tu negdje oko nas.
And favorable condition is around us.
I povoljni uvjeti su oko nas.
But if we don't have eagerness,
ali ako nemamo dovoljno snažnu želju,
to use this beautiful, favorable condition,
kako bismo iskoristili te prekrasne povoljne uvjete,
then we can be disappointed.
Tada ćemo biti razočarani.
So it's very important that each sadaka recognize and be aware of these favorable conditions.
Zato je jako važno da svaki sadaka uoči ove povoljne uvjete i odgovarajuću pomoć.
Sometimes our ego, our materialistic mind, bodily consciousness doesn't allow us to recognize these favorable conditions.
I ponekad nam ego, uvjetovani um, osjetila ne dozvoljavaju da prepoznamo te povoljne uvjete.
We have a help in front of our nose, but we don't see it.
Imamo pomoć ispred svog nosa, a ne vidimo to.
So this is misfortune, actually.
I to je velika nesreća.
I wanted to say like this. Gurudev, do you want to help us?
Wonderful. Very nice.
Please help us.
No,
save us.
Very good. Very nice. I'm meditating how to improve myself.
Goran je zamolio Gurudeva da, da nam pomogne, da se on uključi. Gurudev kaže, ja meditiram kako da pomognem samom sebi.
It's not possible to get so favorable condition in life that we are in Vrindavan.
Nemoguće je dobiti povoljnije uvjete od tih kada smo u Vrindavanu.
And Guru Kripa is there. Vaishnava Association is there.
I Guru Kripa je tu, i Društvo Bhakta je tu.
All the favorable conditions are there.
U Vrindavanu su svi povoljni uvjeti.
But it's still seriousness not comes.
Ali i dalje ne postajemo ozbiljni.
Srinath.
Why, Gurudev, why we are not getting serious?
Pitala sam i zašto nismo ozbiljni, zašto ne postajemo ozbiljni.
Missing indeed.
Nedovoljno snažna želja.
how wonderful is the Goswami's loyalty to the lotus feet of Sri Radha.
Sri Radha.
Kako je predivna lojalnost Goswamija prema Sri Radhikinim lotosovim stopalima.
Srimad Prabodhananda Sarasvati has written in Radharasa Sudhaniti.
Srimad Prabodhananda Sarasvati napisao je u Radharasa Sudhanidhi.
Nothing else can please my mind.
Ništa ne može zadovoljiti moj um.
Than the nectar rasa of the maid servanthood of some most amazing jewel of adolescent girls from the outskirts of Vrindavan.
Osim nektarske rase, služenja najdivnijeg dragulja među mladim djevojkama u području Vrindavana, u području Vrađe.
It is natural.
Is it the one-pointedness? This sometimes people miss. That what I want to practice.
To je jedna usmjerenost, to je ono što nam nedostaje. Ne znamo što želimo prakticirati.
How to do it.
Ne znamo kako prakticirati.
Favorable circumstances.
Ne znamo kako iskoristiti povoljne okolnosti.
Then the all favorable circumstances come. Then mind is so many pointed. Practice is not just staying in one pointed.
I kad se pojavi sve te povoljne okolnosti, um je rasut na sve strane i ne može se fokusirati, ne može biti jednousmjeren.
Not ready to listen that. If they're ready to listen, then Maya affecting to confuse us many things. And all when this favorable and mercy is there, then she is ready to accept us.
Um se jednostavno ne može fokusirati i Maja ga uznemirava i stalno skreće um na različite strane i zbog toga jednostavno ne možemo biti fokusirani, ne možemo biti jednousmjereni.
It is natural that nothing then pleases the mind anymore.
Prirodno je da ništa više ne može zadovoljiti um.
Because raga anuga bhakti is a mental religion.
Budući je raga nuga bhakti religija uma, odnosno mentalna religija.
As Sri Vishnava Chakravarti said,
mental religion means if the mind is not one-pointed, it will not.
Mentalna religija znači ako um nije jedno usmjeren, to neće funkcionirati.
You no need physical activities in this.
Zato nam nisu potrebne tjelesne djelatnosti.
Physical activities do or not do, that is no business.
Sve ne da li radimo tjelesne djelatnosti ili ne, važno je samo da je um jedno usmjeren.
That is meaning of mental religion.
To je značenje mentalne religije, odnosno religije uma.
Body is acting, no problem. But mind is has to be one pointed.
Tijelo može funkcionirati, ali um mora biti jedno usmjeren.
Yeah.
There is no necessity of spiritual injunctions.
Ne postoji nužnost za duhovna pravila.
Why? Because physical activities is not necessary.
Zašto? Jer fizičko djelovanje nije neophodno.
Mind, careful and watchful to your mind. You listening or not listening? He is moving in one direction or many directions. That means mental.
Mentalna religija uma znači da budemo vrlo pažljivi, da obratimo pažnju da li um sluša ili ne, da li je jedno usmjeren ili skreće na različite strane.
There is no necessity of spiritual injunctions for lobha, eva, pravartakaha. Only sacred greed is the inaugurator.
Nisu bitne upute spisa, jedino je potrebna sveta pohlepa. Ona je pokretač.
Loha, eva,
pravartakaha.
Showing. My intention of greediness show me the way to the mind.
Intenzitet moje želje pokazuje put, smjer moga uma.
The Bluetooth device is ready to tell.
What is it?
Even the devotees of the Supreme Personality of Godhead cannot experience the beauty of the thoughts of Sri Radha's maid servant.
Again.
Even the devotees of the Supreme Personality of Godhead cannot experience the beauty of the thoughts of Sri Radhika's maid servant.
Čak ni bakte, svevišnje božanske osobe, ne mogu iskusiti ljepotu razmišljanja Šri Radikinih sluškinja.
Why, you know? Ritual injection go with physical activities. A Radha, Rani service go with a mental relation, two way.
Tu se radi o dva puta. Religijski put slijedi pravila, a put radikinih sluškinja slijedi emocije.
You have a freedom in physical activities. You keep mind where you like.
U fizičkim djelatnostima imamo slobodu i um može biti gdje god želi.
But there is no freedom for the mind.
Ovdje nema slobode za um.
No meaning for your physical activities. No counting for that. But every point is a meaning for your mind. How you're moving.
Ovdje je poanta u umu. Ovdje je jako važno u kom smjeru nam ide um. I nije bitno kako izvana tjelesno djelujemo, nego u što usmjeravamo svoj um. To je jedino važno.
So, in Hindi, they say Mansi Seva, from mind service. Is all activities is Mansik Seva.
Na Hindiju se to kaže Manasi Seva, znači služenje iz uma. Sve se dešava služenjem u umu.
So, Vrindavan, when we come, we never understand, we cannot understand any devotee who is in Mansi Seva and he outly his activities very difficult to understand.
Kad dođemo u Vrindavan, vrlo je teško razumjeti bhakte, što se dešava u njihovom umu. Ne možemo to procijeniti samo na osnovu njihovog vanjskog tjelesnog djelovanja.
Because we have a practice to calculate with the physical actions, huh? But they are in Mansi Seva and we cannot see that.
Jer mi sve radimo kroz tjelesno djelovanje, sve uvijek kalkuliramo kako da izvana djelujemo, a kod njih nije tako, to se izvana ne vidi jer oni su u Manasi Sevi.
And this is spiritual life, not religious.
Kaže Goranga, i to je duhovni život. Tu nije riječ o religiji, znači to služenje u umu i gdje nam je um, to je duhovni život.
We can practice religious life with our bodies and mind can be in all universe.
Religijsku praksu možemo prakticirati tijelom, a um može biti u svim univerzumima.
No problem. There is no meaning for the mind.
Um nema problema. Um je slobodan, neovisan, može ići gdje god želi.
He is free to go.
My practice is not mental. My religion is what you say?
Mental.
Spiritual injunction.
Okay.
My activities is my devotion and by my activities I show to others that I am a devotee.
Religijsko djelovanje je djelovanje tijelom i kroz svoje djelovanje tijela ja pokazujem drugima da sam bhakta svojim vanjskim djelovanjem.
And I'm judging others.
I prosuđujem druge, kaže Goranga.
But in the spiritual life, deep, mind is important, heart is important. And this is the practice.
A u duhovnom životu um je bitan da ide duboko, srce je bitno i to je onda duhovni život i duhovna praksa.
And Prabhupada is saying, Gurudev, in Chaitanya Charitamrita, this is antara seva. Inner seva.
Prabhupada u Chaitanya Charitamriti kaže to je antara seva, odnosno unutarnja seva.
seva sadhak rupena, siddha rupena, anta seva is a siddha rupa, chhatrahi. That is chhatrahi, that is the topmost seva.
Antara seva je sida seva, to je unutarnja seva i chhatrahi to je najuzvišenija seva.
If you come in sadhak deha, you do your activities, but inside activities are more important than outside.
Kad smo u sadhaka tijelu, mi djelujemo izvana, ali ono što je bitno su kako djelujemo iznutra, naša unutarnja seva, to je bitno.
Sila, Bua.
Even the devotees of the Supreme Personality of Godhead cannot experience the beauty of the thoughts of Sri Radha's maidservant.
Sri Radha.
Čak ni bhakte, svevišnje božanske osobe, ne mogu iskusiti ljepotu misli Sri Radhikinih sluškinja.
So Krishna, so he wants to become Chaitanya, to take the shelter of Radhika, mood of Radhika, to Radhish Manjari form.
I zato je Krishna htio postati Chaitanya kako bi kušao to raspoloženje Radhikinih sluškinja.
Because this subject is foreigner to him. He was foreigner for this subject himself. Why Manjari is Radhika devotees are more higher than my devotee. We want to understand that.
Njemu je to bilo strano. Zašto su Radhikine sluškinje više, veće bhakte od mene? On je to morao iskusiti. Za njega je to bilo potpuno strano i zato je postao Chaitanya.
Ano.
It's saying that they cannot experience the beauty of the thoughts of the Manjaris.
Yeah.
So it means Manjaris only think beautiful, and that's why you say we should only think positive in life.
She cannot think negative. If she is a Manjari, she cannot think anything negative.
Gopinath je pitao, kaže, znači, niko ne može iskusiti ljepotu razmišljanja Radhikinih sluškinja. Da li to znači, kad Gurudev kaže da uvijek trebamo razmišljati pozitivno, Gurudev kaže da, to upravo to znači. Radhikine sluškinje su uvijek pozitivne, jer one u stvari održavaju njezine emocije.
So, Krishna, devotee can think many things. Because they are free to think physically, they have to show. But here, mind is not.
Krišnini bhakti mogu svašta misliti, jer oni djeluju izvana, oni djeluju tjelesno, a gdje im je um, to nije bitno.
Subject. Very crystal clear.
Prekrasna tema, kaže Gurudev, sve tako kristalno jasno.
There is no order and supply business.
U tome nema biznisa, nema naručivanja i dobivanja. No Amazon consciousness.
You only have to give your time, mind, your heart, and self.
Jedino trebamo dati vrijeme, srce, um i ništa drugo, potpuno se prepustiti i služiti.
Without telling to her, she have to ready to serve that.
Moramo biti spremni služiti čak i kad nam ona to ne kaže.
My loving Manjari become mad now. She is so much in painting and she is living in that bhava. And when I talk, I can feel she has no time to make her hair even.
Guru Dev se obraća Labangalati i kaže, ona je potpuno postala luda od zanosa, samo slika, nema više vremena ni svoju kosu srediti, toliko je sva u zanosu, luda od emocija, duhovnih.
The beauty in the Vaishnava scriptures, the glories of the Ekanta, one-pointed devotee, are specifically sung.
U vaishnavskim spisima posebno su opjevane slave Ekanta Bhakta, jedno usmjerenih Bhakta.
Ekanta means other thing they don't like to do. This is Ekanta. There are many activities are going on, but they are so alone, they don't want to go out from the thinking asmaran what they are doing.
Ekanta znači biti potpuno usmjerena uma. Postoje tolke druge vanjske stvari koje se dešavaju, ali takvi bhakte, oni žele skrenuti od svoje smarane. Oni jednostavno uvijek su fokusirani na svoj cilj. Uvijek su jedno usmjereni.
All become disturbance.
Sve drugo postaje uznemirenje.
Srila Rupa Goswami writes in Bhakti Rasamrita Sindhu.
Srila Rupa Goswami piše u Bhakti Rasamrita Sindhu.
Of all the devotees, those one-pointed devotees whose hearts have been stolen by Govinda are the best.
Od svih bhakta, oni koji su jedno usmjereni, čije je srce ukrao Govinda, najuzvišeniji su.
Even the mercy of Shrisha, Lord Vishnu, the husband of the goddess of fortune, cannot take their minds away.
Čak ni milost Šriše, odnosno gospodina Višnua, supruga Božice sreće, ne može skrenuti njihove umove.
The one-pointed loyalty of Shradika's maidservants is even more wonderful than the one-pointed loyalty of Krishna's devotees.
Da.
Jednousmjerena lojalnost Radikinih sluškinja još je čudesnija od lojalnosti Krišninih bhakta.
they do not even want Shri Krishna's grace without that of a Radha.
Yeah.
Oni ne žele čak ni Krišninu milost bez Rade.
Their hearts are exclusively surrendered to Shri Radhika's lotus feet.
Njihova su srca isključivo predana Shri Radhikinim lotosovim stopalima.
Tavai vasmi, tavai vasmi, na jiva mi tvaya vina. I am yours only. I cannot live without you.
Ja sam tvoja, ja sam samo tvoja. Ne mogu živjeti bez tebe.
Is the slogan that proclaims their loyalty to Radhika's lotus feet.
Ova izjava javno objavljuje njihovu lojalnost Radhikinim lotosovim stopalima.
Srila Raghunathas cannot tolerate even the idea of worshipping Shri Krishna without Shri Radha.
Shri Radha.
Shri Raghunathas ne može podnijeti ni pomisao da obožava Shri Krishnu bez Shri Radhe.
And this is the main symptom of someone who takes complete shelter of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. Gaudiya Vaishnava.
This is Gaudiya.
This is Gaudiya Vaishnava. If we don't understand ultimate Siddhanta conclusion, then we will miss the point.
Ovo je simptom onih koji su uzeli puno utočište Shri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu-a. I ako, ovo je konačna Siddhanta Gaudiya Vaishnava i ako to ne razumijemo, onda ne možemo jednostavno shvatiti poantu.
Prabhupada said, even for the primary students, they said sometimes, for them also he said 10-10 in Bhagavad Gita.
Prabhupada je čak i za svoje učenike koji su tada bili početnici naglasio stih 10-10 iz Bhagavad Gita.
But he is not for primary students. He writes for everyone who is real, want to elevate themselves.
Ali on nije pisao samo za početnike, on je pisao za sve koji žele ići dalje.
They know one day will come, they have to understand.
Znao je doći će dan kada će oni to moći razumjeti.
So it was for beginner, it was for middle and for the very senior devotee. This book is Bhagavad Gita, is for everyone. How you realize, you understand that.
Ova Bhagavad Gita je za sve, za početnike, za one na srednjem stupnju i za vrlo napredne. Samo ovisi od toga kako ćemo je razumjeti.
Even the Bilav Kosumanjali, what we are reading, is also similar. Beginners, more senior, and more senior, who is very elevated, all they meditate this book.
Naslišan naši Nivilapa Kusumanđali koje čitamo, ona je isto tako za početnike, za srednje i bakte i za bakte koji su vrlo napredni. Svi oni je čitaju i mogu jako puno dobiti iz nje.
In his Sva Niyam Dashaka, Raghunathas has written.
U Sva Niyama Dashaki, Raghunathas je napisao.
Not even for a moment will I go.
Ni na trenutak neću otići.
Near that impure place.
Neću očiti, ni na trenutak neću otići na to nečisto mjesto.
Where a proud hypocrite worships Govinda alone.
Gdje ponosni licomjeri obožavaju Krišnu, samoga Govindu. Samoga, znači.
While neglecting
this line, I want to...
Not even for a moment
will I go neću otići.
Near that impure place,
do tog nečistog mjesta,
where a proud hypocrite worships Govinda alone.
Gdje ponosni licemjeri obožavaju samog Govindu.
While neglecting or disrespecting his most expert lover, Sri Gandharva.
Zanemarujući ili nepoštujući njegovu najvoljeniju Sri Gandharvu Radu.
Whose glories are sung by the Vedic scriptures.
Čije slave pjevaju vedski spisi.
And great sages like Narada Muni, who carries the vina.
I uzvišeni sveci poput Narade Munija koji nosi vinu.
This is my solemn vow.
To je moj svečani zavjet.
Whoever carries Radhika's lotus feet in the heart has such a beautiful mind.
Svatko tko u srcu nosi Radhikina lotosova stopala posjeduje takav prekrasan um.
Gurude, I cannot resist. Actually, so many Gaudiya Acharyas written very similar words in their different books.
Zapravo, mnogi Gaudiya Acharye su spomenuli vrlo sličnu izjavu u svojim pjesmama, u svojim knjigama.
So it means that even in their time, so many people were worshipping Krishna without Radha.
Što znači da je u njihovo vrijeme mnogo ljudi obožavalo Krišnu bez Rade.
And they knew that in the future also many Krishna's devotees will come, but they don't want Radhika.
I znali su da će u budućnosti se pojaviti mnoge bhakte koji će htjeti Krišnu, ali ne Radu.
And they say this is actually disease.
I oni to nazivaju bolešću.
Disease of proud hypocrisy.
Bolest ponosnog licemjerja.
Because if they want to worship God without his love, this is most, I don't know which word to say, this is proudness, hypocrisy, ignorance.
Yeah, if I will develop my hypocrisy, love will be a problem for me. I need hypocrisy. Why I go in the clutch of love? For them, is a love is a fire. They will touch and they will burn out because they need to be glorify hypocrisy, and they want to glorify not love. Love is poison. The milk will break down. is a God. He is an order and supply. What you order, they will supply you.
Goran je rekao, kaže, tu se radi o tome da su ti sve osobe su željele obožavati Boga bez njegove ljubavi. Gurudev kaže, da, za njih oni su na nivou kupi-prodaj, daj, ja sam naručio i ti mi daj ono što sam naručio. I za njih je, oni su licemjeri i za njih je ljubav poput otrova ili poput vatre u kojoj će izgorjeti zato što ne odgovara tim njihovim prohtjevima.
The moment I will introduce Radharani, the mood of Krishna will change. So for the benefit, for my benefit, I don't, if you see that, I don't see that.
Ako spomenem Radharani, odmah će se raspoloženje promijeniti. Zato zbog vlastite dobrobiti ne želim je spominjati, ne želim da ona bude tu prisutna.
They don't introduce that.
I zato je ne spominju.
Honestly, I say you.
Iskreno kažem.
You cannot order.
To vam iskreno kažem, jer tada više ne vrijede ta pravila.
In real pure love, there is no place for proudness and hypocrisy.
No, sure.
That only support. Only submission.
U pravoj ljubavi nema mjesta za ponos, za licemjerje, već samo podređenost.
Then exchange.
That is a different way through the Radhika. One way direct go to Krishna. This is there, right? What is the line again? Repeat, I forget very fast. What is that mean? Yes.
Of all the devotees. Not even for a moment will I go near that impure place where a proud hypocrite worships Govinda alone.
Ni na trenutak neću ići na nečisto mjesto gdje ponosni licemjeri obožavaju samog Govindu.
While neglecting or disrespecting his most expert lover, Sri Gandharva.
Zanemarujući ili ne poštujući njegovu najvoljeniju Sri Gandharvu Radu.
Whose glories are sung by the Vedic scriptures and great sages like Narada Muni who carries the vina.
O čijim slavama pjevaju vedski spisi i uzvišeni sveci poput Narada Munija koji nosi vinu.
That is my solemn vow.
To je moj svečani zavjet.
Doesn't this mean internally rather than externally? I don't feel it means I will physically not go to that place. I feel I don't want to be a hypocrite. I have to keep my mind and my heart always in other Rani's lotus feet.
Right.
And if I don't do, I'm the hypocrite, not other Rani.
No, that is not my. I have to think like this.
Yeah.
Not my physical body is talking.
So I not say you that person is hypocrite, that person is
no,
hypocrite.
No.
If I do Krishna alone,
then I am hypocrite. Mm-hmm. If I don't need to see others what they do.
Yes.
If I do that, what is the difference me and them? Mm-hmm. Then my mind is moving to them to watch it.
Any moment if I not do with love means I'm the hypocrite.
Hypocrite. I have to check only myself, not to ritual injunction people checking others.
Yeah.
You follow that practice, then I will think that you are devotee. It's not
the impure place is my heart, I'm the hypocrite.
Yes.
Not other person.
No, never. Never to see other what they do. But if my mind is not doing that, I'm hypocrite.
Gopika je ovdje unijela svoj komentar i kaže ovaj pojam ponosni licemjeri prvenstveno se odnosi na nas. Mi moramo provjeravati, voditi računa gdje je naš um, a ne prosuđivati druge i reći eto oni idu tamo, oni su licemjeri, ja sam bolji i tako dalje. To je pogrešno. Ako ne prosuđujemo sebe, ako ne vodimo računa o tome o čemu mi mislimo, u što je usmjeren naš um, tada smo potpuno isti i mi smo također onda samo ponosni licemjeri.
Not to others, then is a ritual injunction people, categories.
Uvijek moramo prosuđivati sebe, ne druge, jer inače opet djelujemo poput ljudi koji se pridržavaju samo ritualnih pravila i propisa.
Jai ho, Gopika Didi. Whoever carries Radhika's lotus feet in the heart has such a beautiful mind.
Svatko tko u srcu nosi Radhikina lotosova stopala posjeduje takav predivan um.
Srila Raghunath Das cries in anguish.
Srila Raghunath Das plače u tjeskobi.
And then, by the mercy of Srimati, he gets a vision of his gradual morning services.
I tada milošću Srimati dobiva viziju redoslijeda jutarnjih službi.
Swamini lies to sleep on her jewel bedstead.
Swamini leži i spava na krevetu od dragulja.
That is as white as the foam of milk.
Poput je bijel, poput mliječne pjene.
Exhausted of her nocturnal pastimes.
I umorna je od svojih noćnih zabava.
In her dream, Krishna Mayi, Sri Radhika, who is always absorbed in Krishna consciousness, relishes the sweetness of Mohana.
U snu, Krishna Mayi, odnosno Radhika, koja je uvijek zaokupljena svjesnošću Krishne, uživa u Sri Mohanovoj slatkoći.
This is clearly visible on the expression of her beautiful face.
To je jasno vidljivo po izrazu njezina prekrasna lica.
The Sakis and Manjaris understand everything about her wealth of ecstatic love.
Sakije i Manđari u potpunosti poznaju svo blago njezine zanosne ljubavi.
At that moment, Sri Radhika's maternal grandmother Mukara enters and says.
U tom času u sobu ulazi Mukara, koja je Radhikina baka s majčine strane, koja izgovara.
O Rade, my dear granddaughter, where are you?
O Rade, draga moja unuko, gdje si?
hearing Mukara's calls and being prodded by her sakis, Srimati slowly wakes up and sits on her bed.
Začuvši Mukarin glas, istodobno malo potaknuta sakijama, Srimati se polagano budi i sjeda na krevet.
Mukara then sees Krishna's yellow dhoti that Radhika accidentally put on before leaving Krishna in the end of the night on her body and says,
Mukara tada opaža Krishnin žuti dhoti koji Radhika slučajno stavila na sebe prije nego što se u zoru rastala od njega i zato joj se obraća.
And says with a highly suspicious mind.
Obraća se sa vrlo sumnjičavim umom.
Alas, alas, what is this?
Avaj, avaj, što je to?
Ovišake, last evening I saw this yellow cloth on Krishna and now I see it on your saki.
O Višake, sinoć sam ovu žutu odjeću vidjela na Krišni, a sada je na tvojoj prijateljici.
What kind of behavior is this for a married girl?
Kako je to ponašanje za udatu djevojku?
When Višaka hears Mukara's words and sees Krishna's yellow cloth on her saki,
kada
she
Višaka,
is initially alarmed.
Kada je Višaka vidjela tu žutu Krišninu odjeću na svojoj saki i čula Mukarine riječi, ona se u prvom trenu zaprepastila.
But then she gets herself together again and says,
a zatim se sabrala i izgovorila,
O bewildered grandmother,
O zbunjena bako,
you mistake the golden net of morning sun rays that pierce through the window and shine on my saki's blue garment to be a yellow garment.
Pomiješala si zlatne sunčeve zrake koje ulaze kroz prozor i sjaje po plavoj odjeći moje saki sa žutom odjećom.
Don't be vainly afraid.
Nemoj se nepotrebno uzrujavati.
While Vishaka says this, Tulasi immediately takes Mohana's yellow cloth off Swamini's limbs and exchanges it for Srimati's usual blue garment.
Dok je Višaka to izgovarala, Tulasi je na brzinu skinila Mohanovu žutu odjeću sa Swamini i zamijenila je s njezinom uobičajenom plavom.
When Mukara looks again and sees the blue dress, she becomes ashamed of her mistake and goes off.
Kada je Mukara ponovno pogledala, vidjela je plavu odjeću, pa se zastidjela i povukla.
Then Lalita and Vishaka and all the other sakis bathe and dress themselves and enter into Srimati's bedroom.
A Lalita, Vishaka i ostale sakije u međuvremenu su se okupale, presvukle i ušle u Srimatinu sobu.
Where they become like stars that surround the Radha moon in the evening sky.
Izgledale su poput zvijezda koje okružuju Radha mjesec na noćnom nebu.
When the sakis come together, different waves of Parihasta rasa, playful joking, well up.
Čim su se sakije okupile, nastupili su valovi parišara rase, odnosno to je razmjena veselih šala.
Meanwhile, Shyamala Sakhi, who is very eager to hear Srimati's passionate rasodgara, recollection of previous amorous pastimes and their concomitant emotions, arrives at Yavat.
U međuvremenu u Yavat je došla Shyamala Sakhi, koja je jako voljela slušati o Šrimatinoj strastvenoj rasodgari, odnosno voljela je slušati sjećanja na ljubavne zabave i njihove popratne emocije.
Srimati blissfully embraces Shyamala and seats her close to her.
Srimati je radosno zagrlila Shyamalu i posjela je pokraj sebe.
Full of anuraga, Srimati then says, Sakhi Shyamale.
Prepuna anurage, Srimati joj rekla, Sakhi Shyamale.
Just as I thought about you, you came.
Baš kad sam pomislila na tebe, ti si se pojavila.
O Sakhi, if the tree of my desires bears fruits, I will consider this to be a good morning.
O Sakhi, ako drvo mojih želja daje plodove, onda ću ovo jutro smatrati vrlo povoljnim.
Alas, I don't know when I will be able to see this most ecstatic fruit.
Alas, ne znam kada ću moći vidjeti to najzanosnije voće.
Shyamala jokingly replies.
A Shyamala u šali odgovara.
O Sakhi Radhe.
O Sakhi Radhe.
Your lips have even become bruised from tasting these fruits from the tree of your yearning.
Usne su ti zgrebane od kušanja tog voća s drveta tvojih želja.
And the red juice has stained your eyelids.
A crveni sok obojio je tvoje očne kapke.
And still, you say that this tree has not borne fruit yet. How amazing.
A ti i dalje govoriš da to drvo ne donosi plodove. Kako čudno.
Sri Radhika replied.
A Sri Radhika odgovara.
O Shyame. You joke about me because you don't know my heartache.
O Shyame, šališ se na moj račun jer ne poznaješ bol u mom srcu.
Just as the lightning illuminates the cloudless night just once.
Kao što munja nakon što jednom osvjetli nebo bez oblačka.
First destroying the darkness and then disappearing again, making the darkness twice as dense as before.
Dakle, kao što munja nakon što jednom osvjetli nebo bez oblačka, a najprije odagna tamu, a potom nestane, učinivši je dvostruko mračnijom, na sličan način.
Similarly, after having seen Krishna just once, his disappearance doubles the misery of his absence.
Na sličan način, nakon što sam jednom ugledala Mohana, njegov je nestanak udvostručio bijedu zbog njegovog odsustva.
The hearts of the Sakis and Manjaris are like fishes.
Srca Sakija i Manjari su poput riba
that swim on the waves of this ocean of Srimati's passionate rasodgara with Shyamala.
Poput riba su što plivaju u valovima oceana Srimatine strastvene rasodgare sa Mohanom.
Then Madhurika Sakhi arrives from Nanda's village and tells Srimati how Purnamasti came to Yashoda's abode.
Tada je stigla iz Nandinog sela Madhurika Sakhi i ispričala Srimati kako je Purnamasi došla kod Yashode te su zajedno probudile Krišnu.
How Yashoda and Purnamasi woke Krishna up, how they washed his face, and how they worshipped him along with Baladev.
Znači kako su probudile Krišnu, umile ga, obožavale zajedno s Baladevom.
How Krishna ate makhan mishri, butter with rock candy, his favorite savory.
Kako je Krišna pojeo makarana mišri, omiljen maslac sa kockom šećera, to je njegov omiljen slatkiš.
And how Krishna took Baladev and his cowherd boyfriend along to the goshala to milk the cows.
I kako je Krišna sa svojim prijateljima, pastirima i Baladevom otišao u gošalu pomusti krave.
After making Srimati relish the nectar of Krishna's morning pastime, Shyamala and Madhurika leave.
Nakon što je Srimati uživala u slušanju tog nektara Krišninih jutarnjih zabava, Shyamala i Madhurika su otišle.
As long as these two Sakis were there, the fire of Radhika's separation was somewhat under control.
Dok su te dvije Saki bile prisutne, vatra Radhikine odvojenosti donekle je bila pod kontrolom.
But after they left, its flames rose up high again.
Međutim, nakon što su one otišle, ti goreći plamenovi odvojenosti ponovo su se rasplamcali.
Bhavini means Radha, who is mad with ecstatic love for Krishna.
Bhavini znači Radha, koja je luda od ljubavi prema Krišni.
And the pinnacle of that ecstasy has now been reached.
I sada je dosegnut vrhunac tog zanosa.
The Kinkaris know how to serve Swami in such a way that this fire of separation can be extinguished or at least pacified.
Kinkari znaju kako služiti Svamini da bi tu odvojenost, tu vatru odvojenosti ugasile ili barem ublažile.
They keep the pictures of Mohana and his pastimes marked in their hearts and carry them along wherever they go.
One drže Mohanovu sliku i njegove zabave u svojim srcima i nose ih gdje god idu.
The maidservants have learned all the arts of service from Shyama.
Sluškinje su sve ove vrste ekspertnog služenja naučile od Shyame.
Tulasi comes with fragrant clay and camphor-scented water and starts anointing Swamini's hands and feet with these natural unguents as part of her morning service.
Tulasi dolazi s mirisnom glinom i vodom namirisanom kamforom te počinje premazivati Svaminine ruke i stopala tim prirodnim sastojcima kao dijelom svoje jutarnje službe.
Tulasi is very expert in washing and rubbing Virahavati Shrimati's lotus feet with soft camphor-scented clay.
Tulasi je vrlo vješta u pranju i brisanju lotosovih stopala Virahavati Svamini s tom mekom glinom.
And washing them with camphor-scented water.
I namočivši ih sa vodom namirisanom kamforom.
She knows how the touch of Mohana's hand feels, and she tries to touch Swamini exactly as he touches her.
Ona vrlo dobro zna kakve osjećaje Mohanovi dodiri Mohanove ruke pobuđuju Svamini i stoga je nas to i dodirivati jednako kao i on.
She opens her braided hair and dries Shrimati's feet off with them.
Tulasi raspiče svoju pletenicu i suši Svaminina stopala s njom.
Because that is softer than with the bare hands.
Jer zna da je to mekše od golih ruku.
Just as she stretches out her hand to start massaging, she doesn't feel his lotus feet anymore.
I baš kad je ispružila ruku kako bi započela s masažom, najednom više ne osjeća Radikina stopala.
The transcendental vision has faded away and Raghunath feels the same heartache of separation again.
Transcendentalna vizija je nestala i Raghunath opet osjeća bol odvojenosti u svom srcu.
Taking his strong desire in his heart, he then laments over the lost devotional service in his sadak avesh.
U svom sadak avešu s dubokim bolom opet jadikuje za izgubljenom devocijskom službom.
O Bhavini, when can I carefully wash your lotus feet each morning in your house?
O Bhavini, kada ću u tvom domu svakog jutra brižno prati tvoja lotosova stopala?
With camphor-scented clay and wash them with fragrant water.
S glinom namirisanom kamforom i isprati ih mirisnom vodom.
When will I wipe your lotus feet dry with my open braid of curly locks.
Kada ću sušiti tvoje lotosova stopala s uvojcima svoje raspletene pletenice.
Vilapa Kusumanjali is the greatest treasure.
Vilapa Kusumanjali najveće je blago.
Filled with all the different wonderful vows of devotional service.
I ispunjena je različitim, zadivljujućim zavjetima služenja s ljubavlju.
O Haripad, always get up in the Brahma Muhurta hours and remember this blissful devotional service.
O Haripada, uvijek ustani u vrijeme Brahma Muhurte i sjećaj se ove blažene devocijske službe.
The end of verse 19.
Kraj stiha 19.
Yeah, thank you.
Thank you, Gurudev, that you engage us in this, that you engage us in this beautiful Shravanam, Kirtanam, Smaranam.
Still, I cannot do. Pray for me that it happens soon. Yeah.
We need your blessings, Gurudev. And prayers, and all other Vaishnavas.
Yeah.
Radhe, radhe.
Well.